Using breakout rooms in Zoom meetings is a fantastic way to engage your participants, especially if you are doing any type of teaching or training. However, there's a good chance that you may want to pre-assign your breakout rooms. So in today's video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about how to pre-assign your participants within your Zoom meetings. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And let's start things off with getting into our settings. You'll need to log into your Zoom account within a web browser, and we want to click on settings on the left-hand side. We're going to scroll about halfway down the page before we get to the header, which is labeled In Meeting Advanced, and then the second option below says Breakout Room. Now, you probably already have Breakout Room enabled, but we need to make sure that you also have this checkbox checked. Allow host to assign participants to breakout rooms when scheduling. This is a must. This is allowing us to pre-assign those participants to those breakout rooms. With that checked, we can now go back to our meetings area and schedule our meeting. I'm going to hit schedule a meeting. Let's just give this a quick test breakout meeting. That sounds good. We can fill out our description and time and so forth, but where I want to pay our attention is down below, under meeting options. So here we now have this option. Because we checked that option in settings, under meeting options, we can now say breakout room pre-assign. Now we've got two choices here available to us. I'm going to show you both, but I'm also going to show you my preference, the one that I think is much easier for you to manage. So the first one here is to create rooms, and a dialogue is going to pop up here. And all we need to do here is start adding rooms by hitting this plus button. If I say plus, it's going to say breakout room 1, breakout room 2, breakout room 3, however many that I need. And on the right hand side, I can start inputting their email addresses. Now, here is a major warning. I want you to listen carefully. Pre-assignment of breakout rooms is only going to work with participants who have a Zoom account. What I mean by that, it's not just that they can access Zoom. Of course, anyone can access your Zoom meetings by just sharing a link, but they must have an actual Zoom account, meaning that they can actually come in here to the Zoom browser and actually log in with their email address and password within their Zoom account. If they don't have an actual Zoom account, then they will not be able to be pre-assigned. They do not need a paid version. I repeat, any Zoom account, just a basic free version is fine, but they have to have an email address and a password to log into Zoom. So here under Create Rooms, as I said before, you can come in here, start creating your rooms, and start adding participants by adding their email addresses. However, this is a little tedious, right? And even creating just two rooms of 10 is going to take you an awful lot of time. As you type in each and every email address, even if you copy and paste them one at a time, it's going to take an awful lot of time as well. So that's why I recommend we choose the second option, import from CSV. We can either do it here from this dialog, or if I hit cancel, we can also hit this option here, import from CSV. So that's going to bring up this dialog window. And before you hit this to actually upload a file, we want to make sure that we download the template. Now, you're only going to have to do this once, because once you have the template, you can use it multiple times and copy it if you need to. So we're going to hit download here. What it's going to do, it's going to download a CSV file, which is going to open up in your spreadsheet application. So for most of us, that's going to be something like Microsoft Excel, like you see here. Now, the template is pretty simple. There's really only two columns, pre-assign room name and email address. And within the template, they've just given us a few simple examples just so we know where to put things. We can immediately go and delete this dummy data right away and start putting in our own. The one thing you want to be careful of, though, is do not touch the two headers at the top. Pre-assign room name and email address. Don't relabel them. Don't change anything about them. This is what Zoom is going to be looking for to make sure that that pre-assignment works out properly. So here in this example, they've just got three rooms and they've got two people in each room. Of course, you can delete this and put in anything you want, right? We could have a bunch of blue rooms and green rooms and yellow rooms. And then over here, we can put in those email addresses. And again, chances are you probably have all of your participants clients' email addresses maybe already in a spreadsheet or some other document, you can just copy and paste them here into this spreadsheet and you're practically ready to go. So now once you save this, now what we're going to do is upload this to our file here. Now I've already created one in advance, so I'm going to click this upload button here and I'm going to go find mine called Test Breakout List A. And here you can see I've created something super simple. I've just got two rooms, the blue group and the red group, and I've got two dummy email addresses that I'm going to be using here. I'm going to select open, and now we return to our breakout room assignment dialog, and you can see they're ready for me. I've got my red group here and I've got my blue group. And the nice thing is if I need to make a few adjustments, I can still do that here. I can still move people between rooms. I can add other participants here. I don't always have to go back to that spreadsheet if I don't want to. I can do some fine tuning at this stage. All you need to do is hit save. Now we can see we've got those two breakout rooms. We can hit save and create that meeting. But let's jump into a meeting that I'm already in where I created a similar type of breakout room. So here I'm in a meeting with two other individuals here and we have not yet started our breakout rooms. So down below, I'm gonna hit more if you don't see breakout rooms, depending on how much room you have here on your Zoom control panel. I'm gonna hit more and I'm gonna say breakout rooms. And here we can see it's already pre-assigned. I just open up the breakout rooms. Chloe is in room one where I wanted her to be and Zoe is in room two. This is perfect. Now I can just open up all rooms and start my breakout room session. Now here's another note that you should be aware of is if people are late to your Zoom meeting and you've already started the breakout rooms, they will not automatically be assigned to those rooms. Even if they have a Zoom account, even if you put them in your spreadsheet, they will not appear here and they will not automatically go into those rooms. They will appear at the top of the screen and then you can just manually assign them to the place where you want. But just remember, if anyone is late, if anyone arrives after you've started the breakout rooms, they will not just jump into those breakout rooms automatically. Now, here's something else that I want to show you as you're dealing with breakout rooms. Chances are you may want to shuffle things up as a part of your training or as a part of your Zoom meeting. So let's say at one point I want to swap Chloe and Zoe within their rooms. I'm going to hit exchange here, and now you see Zoe is in room one and Chloe is in room two. But maybe somewhere later in the meeting, I want everyone to go back to their original breakout rooms, the original ones that I created in advance. Well, all I need to do is come down here to recreate, and we're gonna choose this option, recover to pre-assigned rooms. I'm gonna select that. It's gonna confirm if I want to do it. I'm gonna say yes. And now you can see Chloe is back in room one. Zoe is back in room two, just like I identified or just like I set up in advance. Well, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on pre-assigning participants to Zoom rooms. If you wanna learn even more about how to use breakout rooms, be sure to check out the video in the bottom left. And if you wanna see all of my Zoom meeting tips, be sure to check out the playlist in the bottom right. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and if you enjoyed it, give it a like and subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.